everybody today. We're going to continue talking about this novel, Law of Vibration. It's episode 4, if I'm not mistaken. It might sound alien, but everything indeed carries vibrational energy. Even self-consciousness is energy, music is energy, people's opinions is also energy. And that's why law of vibration exists. Vibrational pattern can calculate anything. Fair use. A portion of this novel contains third-party content, constitute fair use under federal copyright laws, works MGB educational, scholar nature, criticism, and story honestly unbelievably mind-blowing. So please stay and listen to us on other podcasts. Today we're going to talk about Matrix. We already mentioned that in the other episodes. And the chapter 9, Overstock. Others have attempted to tie this to Overstock scandal that happened months prior in August 2019, when CEO of Overstock resigned after issuing statements that he claimed he was involved in political espionage. And Aileen Amenti did used to work for Overstock as well. And she did have meetings with the old colleagues. And if there is a connection, it's honestly outside the realm of the video. And it seems to be the whole other conspiracy theory. Finally, an OCA terrorist, echo terrorist group known as Individualists Tending Toward the Wild, simply ITS, claimed to be responsible for death of Ellen, and as well as another tech CEO, Tusa Amre. And in Tusa's case, he was kidnapped from his house in Santa Cruz on October 1st, 2019, and was found dead next day. However, this claim hasn't been verified, and there is no evidence to suggest the involvement. Oddest aspect of this case, of course, was Ellen's last comments before her disappearance. She claimed, she told her mother, quote, "It's all a game, a thought coincidence, a thought experiment, and we're on in the matrix. It's not coincidence. Whatever has happened is not coincidence. It's all programmed." Even though it's quite bizarre thing for somebody to say this kind of stuff, and it might actually be explainable, but more than that, and I think it's safe to say that most people watching this movie, Matrix, a new one coming soon. So, but just in case you don't know, the Matrix is a philosophical idea that the universe and everything that it's made up is just a simulation. This most popular depicted movie in 1999, where a main protagonist Neo learns that humanity has been enslaved by machines, AI, artificial intelligence. An advanced race of artificial intelligence, and the life he experienced just information being fed to his brain. Quote, "Neo, this is not real. What is real? How do you define real? If you're talking about what you can feel and smell and taste and see, then real is simply electrical signals interpreted by your brain and nothing else. Morpheus from Matrix." And read my other novels, Devil Advocate from Peterson, Matrix, where Leia is a Neo, exploring rabbit hole. Now we don't think that people who believe this idea of Matrix also believe in robots and machines, that robots and machines will overflow humanity one day. But instead they believe that at some point humanity becomes so advanced that human consciousness, something that we currently don't understand now completely, will be understood at the point of being replicable as a storage drive. And so, like many humans usually do, went for it and succeed. Given how advanced technology are right now, so in the past couple of decades, we didn't even have cell phones or, you know, self-driving cars. We didn't have nothing. And now we have more integrated artificial intelligence technology that has been with us every day, and we don't even notice it, taking for granted. Quote, "I wouldn't say it's creating simulation of our world in the next couple hundred years isn't entirely unlikely. And if that's the case, who said that we are not already in simulation? If you assume that any rate of improvement at all we have now, the games will become indistinguishable from reality. That's why Facebook's trying to do with Meta, so you can just put the glasses on and you like in a different reality and feeling like real. It would seem follow the odds and we are in base realities one in a billions. It was quoted by Elon Musk. And the owner of Facebook, Oculus, came up with Meta reality already right away. So why Google and Apple are working hard on augmented reality glasses then? Of course, it's just a theory based on a number of assumptions that make fun for philosophical conversation. But point is, such technology already exists and we can read our movements and virtually replicate them in a simulation. It's already being developed. So, as previously stated, Ellen Amanti, our company ThinkAventure, did endorse this kind of technology, idea of Matrix. And all above combined with Ellen's last words to her family was really mysterious, and her mysterious death had led some to believe that she might have stumbled upon something grand conspiracy involving our world being a simulation. Unfortunately, this was all we had to work with for next couple of months, so no new details about Ellen's death would be discovered, leaving her case a mystery. That was until February 2020, when the cause of death was finally revealed, and according to autopsy reports, Ellen Amanti's death was due to natural causes following the acute maniac episode, though it didn't specify what exactly killed her. Also, Ellen's husband claims she had no previous mental or drug-related issues. Ellen did have a thyroid condition that was related to her it was treated by medication. According to Business Insider, it's possible that Ellen could have died just to this condition, and she thought and she was already taken care of. That blood samples in autopsy shown no satisfactory for analysis. Furthermore, investigation coming into some Ellen's last electronic communication showed symptoms of maniac episode. According to San Jose Medical Examiner Office, they eventually concluded her death was due to undiagnosed psychiatric disorder. They suspected bipolar disorder. Bipolar disorder is defined as illness in which one experiences periods of extremely high moods and extremely low moods. It's like a swing or roller coaster. You can think of these two periods as possible ends of a pole. Bipolar disorder is a condition frequently undiagnosed, and what often follows is a period of depression, irritability, where suicide attempts are common. In Ellen's case, she could have experienced her maniac episode sometime after visiting her friends in Silicon Valley, and this caused Ellen to call her parents and frantically talk about life being a thought experiment in the Matrix. After all, Ellen Company was interested in this kind of technology. Following this conversation, Ellen rushes into the airport and experiences a wave of depression waves. Her vehicle in San Jose neighborhood, she parked her vehicle in... her vehicle in San Jose neighborhood and died shortly after that. If Ellen committed suicide, the method by she chose it was unclear. However, it's not entirely impossible. So in 2015, study conducted by University of South California or San Francisco, they survived 200 entrepreneurs and found that 50% of them having at least one mental health condition. When compared to a small sample of 93 entrepreneurs, they noticeably more likely to report having some mental condition as well. As entrepreneurs were asked to specify on their condition, 30% reported having depression, 20% reported having ADHD, 12% reported having substance abuse, 11% reported bipolar disorder, 27% reported having anxiety. And in comparison to 7% of US population identify themselves as depressed, according to National Institute of Mental Health. So all this would seem to suggest a link between having mental health disorder and entrepreneurship, and it's not too surprising. Take an Aaron Swartz case, for example. He was an entrepreneur and internet activist who mostly known for to be a founder of Reddit. He wrote about his own struggles with depression on his online blog after being arrested, and then he committed suicide. And there are dozens of episodes and articles and examples written on subject. Perhaps Ellen could have been also affected as well. However, because Ellen's body was found a few days after she died, the autopsy report admitted that the findings were inconclusive, and further, her family doesn't believe Ellen was the type of person who could kill herself. Following her death, Ellen's family started an Ellen Amante Woman Entrepreneurship Scholarship with the goal of raising $100,000 for aspiring female entrepreneurs at the University of Utah. Ellen always will be believed and as a good woman, entrepreneur, a smart woman, and that more women should be inspired by her and should pursue entrepreneurship.